along the edge of the... So you're basically moving quietly along the edge of the tree line.
Okay. So, does... I would think Piper would kind of have a little bit of knowledge about how to potentially attack a structure like this.
I would say with a military tactic, she would. Typically, yes, you would use siege engines and catapults and all stuff like that, and you'd probably have 500 or 600 men at your back.
Right.
Most of what you know would kind of go out of the water here because you're not really able to siege this castle in a conventional way. This is more like break in and sneak through till you find the intended victim and bump him off. So this is more like a break-in assassination attempt than an actual siege, to be honest. Of course, if you wish to go bang on the door and start hacking, that's entirely up to you guys.
But, like, does she see any weak points? Because I would think that she would be able to scout. Right.
Some of the walls, especially around the corner towers, like here... like right here, you see these?
No.
Are you able to see what I'm? Okay, there you go.
Can I you don't see your.
Okay,
I don't see your pings, man.
Right.
No.
So
there.
Where the towers are.
Okay.
Some of those are a little crumbled, but of course they're higher up. The actual walls themselves seem to be fairly solid. By the looks of it, however, this area over here, which is where the bridge is. It looks like at one point that was probably a solid stone bridge, but you can see where it has collapsed, and they've kind of made like a makeshift wooden suspension bridge across it. That may be a good place to go up there. The only problem is you can see that there are a bunch of humanoids actively, on guard on that bridge, so they would definitely see you coming.
Okay.
The very fact that this castle is so high up, it's very clear to you with your military background why it is built this way. It is an extremely difficult castle to siege.
Fortress.
Yeah, there's no way to battering ram it. You have to scale it. So, yeah.
Okay.
But, of course, you haven't seen the front side of it to really know, how people would go about getting in or out, so...
It doesn't look like there's any way.
So there's no cover at the front, though, right?
Well, you haven't gotten to the front. You can't see that far.
But you said because that's why we came around the back, because the front wasn't covered.
Yeah,
you mean that the approach to it is not covered yet. The approach is way open. There's a lot of hills and stuff. Once you come out of those hills, you're going to be marching clear, marching blatantly straight across an open area towards the front gate.
How large are these to scale? These, Ooplies?
They're all... yep, they are.
Arr! Okay.
Goodness.
I guess I'm just going to look at Piper and Arya and I'm going to say, see more about the south side? I mean, there seems to be less skeletons there. What do you think, guys?
You think we just sneak attack all of those? At least that one down there?
You could try that. I mean, that's not a bad idea. It'll be tough, though.
We're so loud.
It'll be tough, though. Piper?
I don't see any real weak points, honestly.
Can we, lure the skeleton towards us? Away from, one at a time?
You're talking about the skeleton right here? I'm going to point at the one right in front of the tower.
Yeah, that one. How do we lure it?
I think we just go along the southern part and go here. Like, avoid it,
Just avoid it, okay. If you think it's going to work.
Which way are these two skeletons patrolling? Like, which way are they technically facing?
They vary. They, as I said, they're not really patrolling like with any intelligent method. They're really just kind of wandering around. You see them set about rabbits and rodents routinely. Like anything at all that seems to move around here, you know, you can like watch this skeleton suddenly scuttle off 40 feet and then just hack the crap out of the ground, and a small creature just got butchered. So it's like any, but they're just wandering around constantly, just turning their heads and looking.
All right, so.
But there's no route. They're not patrolling as such.
How about we go south into the forest and emerge further to the west, away from that thing, and we deal with the one over there?
You can see that far?
Can I see that far? I mean, it's...
No, your illumination allows you to see from where you are.
Okay.
To about to here. but, of course... Okay. But
we can't even see the one right in front of us.
It is. Well, you can, because bear in mind, this is all in the open clearing. The moon is full, so you can see the shadows of the figures. You can't see the details of them, but you can see the humanoid moving around.
Okay, so we can see the humanoid moving on the southern embattlement too, down here by the tree. Or is that too far?
That's too far.
That's too far. Okay.
Yeah, I would say about 200 feet. You're good. So maybe to here, you know. So you can see this one, but
good to know. Okay. Yeah.
Let's go.
Well, let's check out the southern battlements.
Lead the way.
Okay, so you skirt through the edge of the forest towards the southernmost side, I guess, over here.
Yeah, like exactly there.
Okay, then move yourselves.
Maybe I don't want to, you know.
Then don't.
I guess.
Now we see that one, correct?
Yes.
Okay. There. I say...
Okay, there you go. Right, so yeah, you can see that one. There's also there is also like more tree cover on this side as well. You're able to see.
I got it.
What?
Arya, ball of tricks to try to get the thing to go to its, not knowing that there are humans there, and then we kill it.
That's a very good idea. I like that idea. That's smart.
Okay.
So I'm gonna skirt along, you know, the trees and be closer, obviously.
Okay.
Like I'm still in the trees.
How close to the tree line are you gonna get? Because you're getting pretty darn close to that skeleton if you go there.
Well, I don't want to alert it, so I guess right there. I don't know. It's the scale of this map is throwing me, so.
Yeah, it's big, huh?
Yeah, it's definitely big.
Yeah, and obviously, you know, your icons are slightly larger than they realistically would be, but if I make them any smaller, no one can see them.
Just be invisible. All right, do it.
Here we go.
Do it.
Right, actually, I can do this. Let's do this.
It's a boar.
Okay, so you summon a boar?
Yeah.
All righty, let's give you a boar.
Boar hype. And I'm going to tell it to go towards the skeleton.
I don't like that boar. I'm going to use this boar.
And then to come back towards us.
Okay, so you basically want it to go and, like, get the skeleton's attention and come back to you.
Yes.
Here you go. There's your boar.
Thank you.
Alrighty.
Prepare yourselves. I'm gonna step back, guys.
Skaldir, thank you for following.
Sword drawn, shield held.
Shh.
Alright, well, no sooner than the boar gets to about here, the skeletal creature sees it and begins immediately charging towards it with its bones rattling. Clang, 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 clang. As the armor that it's wearing is kind of obviously doesn't really fit it, so it's rattling against the bones, making a hell of a noise.
Ooh.
Well, the thing is, of course, it makes these noises all the time, so... Yeah. Alright, so your boar is going to run back, turn around and bolt into your group.
Yes, stay with me.
Okay. Alright, so as the skeletal creature gets to you guys, what's the game?
Silently charge it!
And I'm going to zoom in right here.
Like hell I'm going, arr! But I am going to charge it.
Okay, well, I'm going to move you guys, like... I know that you're on the edge of the clear, on the very edge, but I'm going to keep you, like, you know, there. Okay. All right. So you wish to make a charge attack. Let's make some initiative rolls then for you guys with these little beasties.
Yay!
Okay, so Aria.
I'm doing initiative for the boar.
Ooh. Okay.
Hyper.
Aria 12, Veslar 11.
Boar 2.
Boar is a 2. Ooh. And Pip on a 25. Okay. So as the boar comes running back, the skeletons come clang, clang, clang into the edge of the edge of the trees. Piper, you're first.
Clang into the trees.
Okay, so seeing it's a skeleton, obviously, I'm going to do more of a rather than like a cutting, I'm going to do more of a bludgeoning type swing. So kind of instead of using the blade end, I'm going to use like the
flat side of the sword.
If this is your
sword,
use it like this instead of like this.
Yep,
you know what I mean?
I gotcha.
Yeah.
Alrighty.
Alright, so let's go.
Do it! Or don't do it!
Oh, no.
Clearly the wind resistance against the flat of your blade is too
much.
So
hard, yeah.
Okay. So you don't hit it. Aria.
Second attack. Do I get two attacks, or...? I rolled it, so we can just disregard it if I don't.
Well, yeah, it really depends. I will say yes, just for giggles and grins, because I'd rather say yes than no.
All right, well, that's
oh,
potential
sweet.
Crit.
Right, okay, so yes, you hit it.
Potential crit?
Yep, potential crit indeed. And it is a crit!
You crit your pants!
Hallelujah!
All right, let's roll some damage.
So that will be 15. Oh, it doubled. 30.
So double it 30. Okay. Swinging with the flat part of your blade with all your might, it smashes into the skeletal bony form, shattering it and sending bones to, like, scatter it in all directions. It smashed it to smithereens.
Good job.
It
Good
has
job,
it ceased to be.
Quick. Back.
What?
I'm gonna... It's like back, and then run back into the tree line to see if anything like peers over the edge, or shows itself from the edges.
Okay,
that's what I'm doing.
Okay, so you're kind of trying to see if anything looks over the wall, over the battlements,
and or rounds the corner.
Okay,
yeah.
All right. You sit quietly in the tree line, not moving. A couple of minutes pass, and it doesn't seem like anything has really paid much attention to the massacring of the skeleton.
Hey, I have an idea. I don't see any skeletons. Do you think I should see if there's any secret doors in the area around here?
Oh, that's a good idea. Yeah, give it
a try. So you want to search the base of the rock for any secret entrances?
I guess so. There's 60-foot radius or cone.
Mm-hmm.
So
you're casting Detect Secret Doors, right?
Yeah.
Which will basically cover, like, a 2-square area.
Oh, that's so sad.
60 feet.
I'll do it over here, then.
What about there?
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Right. One thing you... So go ahead and make your... So you cast a spell.
Yeah.
You do not find any secret doors, I'm afraid. However, it is less... deep here than anywhere else you've seen so far.
Okay.
If you, without climbing gear, this is probably the only spot that you've seen that even seems viable that you guys might be able to get up there.
Guys.
Let's do it.
Spot. What do you think?
Yeah, let's go.
Huzzah! No, I'm kidding.
Is your boar going with you? Is your boar going with you, or is it running loose in the forest, snuffling for truffles?
It can't climb. I don't know what to do with it.
It's not a climbing boar.
No.
I'm going to tell it to run away from this madness.
Alrighty.
Go save yourself.
It runs off into the forest, looking
don't
for truffles.
Don't come back, you stupid animal. I love you.
That'll do, pig. That'll do.
That'll do, pig. That'll do. There you go.
Wilbur!
Okay. So what's your game plan? Now, I mean, this is, bearing in mind, this is still pretty steep. It's just not as steep.
We're going to...
Who's the best climber out of us?
Let's see.
I think we should take some of the rope and tie it around each other, so if one of us falls, we can kind of maybe, you know...
Yeah, how tall is this? You're like, so how tall are we trying to scale here?
How far from the bottom to the top of the wall?
Till we can get onto some sort of a platform where we're no longer scaling.
About 200 feet.
Okay. So we definitely need a tie-off system of some sort.
If you get to the top of the wall and fall, the damage will be quite insane.
Yeah.
It's possible that Veslar or Piper might live. Arya, not so much. Arya will bounce.
Put me in the middle, please.
Arya will bounce like a watermelon against a brick wall.
Maybe we should not get hurt and we can haul her up after.
Right. Okay. How strong are crossbow bolts?
Not strong enough to support the weight of a person, if that's what you're thinking.
What if you, like, clump three together? Like, just clump them together, you know? Like, still no? I mean, really?
Well, explain to me what it is you're going to try to do with them.
Okay, I don't have any climbing gear, so my thought process is to utilize the 21 bolts I do have to make things that we can tie off, like in a clump. And not hump, but a clump.
Okay, I'm going to say that holding a crossbow bolt and trying to jam it into hard rock will be nigh on impossible.
There's crevices and shit, man.
You can try that. You definitely can try that.
Can I rub my potentially magical lantern and fly?
Do you wish to rub your potentially magical lantern and see if anything happens?
Sure. Not ideas.
Whatever. Okay.
Nothing happens, huh?
No. Would I be that cliche?
Yes.
I would, but that's why I didn't. Only I would probably make it an Afraity bottle as opposed to a genie. It just comes out and says, oh, thanks very much. Kill.
Okay. All right. Well, I have... Yeah. Go ahead.
Perhaps the most skillful climber can climb and then tie the rope up at the top for us.
I've climbed some things. I mean...
Didn't you have a grappling hook, Beth?
No. I have a bolus.
Standing out in the open, trying to make a plan.
Well, fortunately, you are at the very base of, you are at the very base of the... Here's what I am going to do. Kind of just give you a clearer view of that segment of wall at the top, the battlements. There you go.
How steep is the wall itself? Just the wall, not the rocks leading
the
up to
wall is sheer.
Yeah,
and the and wall is... do you mean how tall is it?
Yeah, like how high up? Just the wall.
Okay, the wall itself is 40 feet. So you've got 160 feet to get to here. And then you got 40 feet of actually climbing up the side of the wall itself.
Okay, so I'm going to tie the rope around myself.
Okay.
And being stronger than Arya and Piper, and strength, I'm going to try to start to scale this thing.
Okay.
I have, like, two daggers. I have a heavy, a boot dagger and that strange wicked-looking dagger.
Right.
So could I try to use that to find crevices and jam them in?
Yeah, you can. You can use them like an improvised climbing, like,
Because I don't care if they break. I mean,
right, yeah, no. You can do that.
And my rope goes 50 foot. I have a 50 foot rope, guys.
Right. So you can basically go up 50 foot and then the rope will still be at the bottom.
Okay.
Well, actually, it'll be about 45 foot because you got probably 5 foot of rope used to tie around your waist. So you'll lose.
Tied around my ankle.
Just so you only have to use a foot worth. There you go.
No, I'll tie it around my waist. And
alrighty.
Piper, Ari, do you have any rope?
Yeah, I do.
Okay.
Didn't you buy me rope because you burnt mine?
I did, yes.
Yes, so you do have 50 foot of rope again.
Yes, I do.
So everybody has 50 foot. So you have 150 foot of rope, so you can almost get to the top in one go.
Well, I'm going to start climbing, I guess. I mean, shit. Let's do this.
Do this thing!
I don't like this idea, but we're doing it.
So you're going to climb. So you will be making a climb check. I will give you +2 for your dagger usage.
Don't yell if you fall, okay? Just take it like a man. Fall silently.
I love it.
So +2, you said.
Yeah.
Be a man.
Be a man. Do the right thing.
I want to be the very best. Climbing up a wall.
I rolled. I don't know what it is.
My climbing sucks. Watch me freaking fall. Okay, no. Okay. Yep, so Veslar, using his daggers and his boot tips, he kind of starts.
Nice.
You know, there's times when he has to, like, test the thing, and sometimes it's not solid enough, but. Okay. Veslar is like. He's like about 45 feet up so far. So at this point, what are you going to do? What's the game plan? Are you going to keep climbing and then take the rope all the way up with you, or is anybody coming up behind you at this point?
I think I should go all the way up, so I'm going to turn back to them and say, tie your rope to my rope so it's longer.
Okay.
And then I'll keep going.
I don't want to do a square knot.
Please don't be a use rope check. I'll be so fucked up.
No, I'm going to assume you guys know how to tie a rope.
We're tying a rope to a rope.
Yeah,
right?
You know how to tie a knot. You're not that. You can't. There's no. You can't get to level 9 and not know how to tie a knot. Just. Yeah. We'll save the rope check for if you try to create a lasso and hurl it and hook it over the top of the battlements or something like that.
Okay, and then I'm going to turn around and I'm going to say, why don't one of you guys climb to where I am now? In case I start tumbling, maybe you can catch me, you know, if I fall, so I don't fall all the way.
I'm not
going to
catch you.
I just stay down here. See, catching Veslar, all that really does is it basically allows him to have his damage and you can have the other half.
What do I do?
It's sharing.
Hey, you sure. Can you imagine Radovan trying to do this in his full play?
It would never happen. His, like, climb is -6 or -7.
All right, so Veslar, you're going to keep climbing?
I'm going to wait for Piper to get to where I am, more or less.
Okay, so she is climbing up.
Yep. Yeah. Okay. So I'm going to anchor in.
Is that your climb roll?
11, yeah.
Okay.
If she's holding onto the rope, I'm going to start hoisting the rope up, too. I mean,
If she's climbing on. Well, here's the thing. Once you're up there, you're hanging precariously on the side. If she's using the rope, it's going to put a lot of strain on you. Because think about it. You're hanging there by the, you know, you got two daggers stuck in. You're kind of sitting there like this, you know, on the edge of the. So if she starts pulling on the rope, you're suddenly going to start getting down. So she either needs to climb free or you have to accept that she's possibly going to pull you down.
I have one dagger, so I can use.
I can give you a +1 for one dagger.
There you go, so 12.
Alright. Okie dokie. You begin to climb up. Well, the good news is you only get 10 feet before you slip and fall.
You okay, Pip?
And it does a couple of points of damage.
Okay.
Make a fortitude save DC of 10. This is to kind of suck up the pain. There you go, no problem.
Nice. Suck it up.
Okay, so you basically, you kind of slip and slide and hit the ground.
Tough.
you twist your ankle just a tad, but, you know, a couple of points of damage, but it doesn't really hurt that bad. You're like,
fuck. No, I'm probably like, fuck!
But quietly. All right, so you can try to climb again.
Yeah. This is the plan, so yep. I need
There's
to
nothing
get up
to say you can't have multiple climb checks, of course. You can also fall multiple times. Okay, this time, however...
Oh, with a plus one.
Right, being a little bit more cautious, you kind of get up, and you are now level with Veslar. So you're now both 45 feet up.
Okay. I'll go now. I'll make the next part, and we'll try to get to the top, I guess.
Okay, so Arya is staying at the bottom?
Yes.
Okay. All right, Veslar.
Pacing.
So the goal here is that should Veslar fall, you're hoping that Piper is strong enough to hold him as opposed to pulling her off the cliff as well. I love it. It's a great plan.
So bad.
It's a great plan, guys.
So bad.
All right, go Veslar. Go
Fuck
Veslar.
My life.
Go Veslar.
Do
go
I still
Veslar.
Get the plus two, man?
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Oh, it's just 12.
12.
Oh,
yeah. Is that with the plus two?
Yeah.
Okay. Right.
You're gonna fall.
Shoot.
Okay, yes. With Veslar's impressive climbing ability...
Shit, man.
He gets... Okay, you get... you're about 15 feet up when suddenly you start to slide and slip towards the... You're kind of like... And you lose your grip. Okay, Piper?
Yeah.
You need to make a strength check to hold his weight.
So that's my strength ability
strength
modifier, right?
D20 plus your ability modifier. Normally, I would give you pluses for the rope, but I'm deducting the same pluses because of his sheer weight and the fact that you have very little to hang on to.
Oh, God.
So let's... There you go.
Oh.
Okay.
Oh.
Whew.
So as you kind of fall, Piper is able to, with it, because she's only hanging on with one dagger. Obviously, she must have got that dagger in really deep with her mighty strength. As she hurls down her right hand and just grabs your wrist as you slumber down. You only take 2 points of damage as you batter against the side of the cliff face.
Fuck. Okay. Okay.
You hear a shh from below.
Shut up! Piper,
we're like kids trying to like break out of their house in the middle of the night to go out drinking underage. Like that's what we're doing right now.
All right, that's it.
Bed sheets. Yeah.
Do you want to try the next climb? I'll tie the rope from my waist, or do you want me to just go again?
Just go.
Oh shit, that hurt a lot. I scraped my weenus.
Scraped your weenus?
Yeah, you know what a weenus is, right, guys?
That's your
weenus.
Yeah.
Is that what that is? I thought a weenus was something from Friends that Chandler Bing.
Oh man! Oh well, that's like statistical analysis or whatever. That's no, the weenus. All right.
Okay. So Veslar attempts to scale the wall again.
Don't be a wuss. Just go.
Shut up.
Be a weenus.
14. So it's slightly better.
A total of 14. Okay. You manage to with the daggers. You are up another 45 feet, so now you're 80 foot up.
Oh, fuck me.
Just so you know, not that I want to scare you or anything, it's a d6 for every 10 feet you fall.
Oh.
It would be an 86 if I fall.
Right now, yeah.
How far am I to the top?
You are halfway up the cliff face.
Oh, are you serious?
Yeah. God. It's you're a little over halfway, because it's 160 feet up, and you're now 90 feet. So,
This is like a horrible idea, man. Why did we even think to do this shit?
I don't know.
Is there any like crevice or things that I can use to bolster something in? Like, there has to be, you know, right? Maybe. I don't want to tie off here if I can possibly help it.
There's nothing to tie to. You're gonna have to jam something in.
Well, yeah, I'll jam something in.
Oh, okay. What are you gonna jam in, Gabriel? Thanks for that follow.
So loud.
Now he sounds like the drunk guy trying to whisper.
Yeah.
This is where climbing spikes would have come in very handy.
Yeah.
Whenever the discussion about sieging a castle came in, I kind of expected you guys to pick up some of those.
Yeah, we're not that smart, man. We're not that smart.
That plan was like, you guys were more in. You're like Frodo, just to get there. just to get there.
Okay.
Whatever I happens, still have happens when we get there.
My magical short spear staff. Can I use that? Because
yeah.
I don't care if it's magical. So yeah. I'm going to jam that shit in there.
Okay, so you're going to slide it out of your backpack and like jam it in. Give me a strength check. Let's see just how high I'll give you. You get plus. You get a plus two. A plus two on that strength check.
So just a regular strength check with plus two.
Yes.
So it's like everything else I've been rolling this time.
Yeah.
Hurrah!
Let's see.
So it's worth like $1,000 or something.
All right. Okay. So you, yeah, you jam it in, and it surprises you just how far the tip does actually go in. Just the tip.
No.
What's really sad is I didn't actually even intentionally say that. That wasn't even just a really bad pun. That just came out legit. Tipster, no one brought a grappling hook with them. Okay, so yeah, you hammer the spear into the rock.
And I'm gonna look back at Piper and I'm gonna say, it's magical, but it's useful too.
It's a magical climbing spike of walking. Okay, so now you have a spear, a magical spear, hammered in 90 feet up a cliff. What do you want to do with it?
Tie a rope around it, and
what
then
rope?
The rope that's been dangling from my waist for 100 feet, because I assume Arya tied that part into. I mean, we tied the ropes together, so we have 150 feet.
Right, so right now the rope goes from you, attaches 45 feet down to Piper, so you can't pull it up. You see what I'm saying? Piper would have to unhook it.
Oh my goodness.
Okay, so I untie it from my waist.
Okay.
And then tie it around the staff.
Okay.
And then retie it around my waist? Right? Because...
Well, how... Yeah, I mean...
I mean, I'd have to have a lot of slack, so...
Well, that's the problem, and the slack is currently 45 feet down where Piper is.
So I'm going to say, Piper, untie yourself for a second. Oh,
okay, Veslar.
Well, obviously, you know, I need to tie it to the spear so we get some anchorage.
I mean, there is a way to achieve this if you think about it.
Yes,
but
we're not
there
that smart.
Isn't a... I mean, you know.
Yeah, I'll do that, and then retie it. You know, kind of slinky it, you know?
Right.
Yeah, it's like give more pressure, so we tie it around the rope and then tie it around myself, and we all tie it around each other. Yeah.
So, Arya's going to tie it to her at the bottom?
I guess so, yes.
Okay, so she will have to start climbing before you get to the top then.
No.
Yeah.
Oh, no, guys. Don't make me.
Alternatively, you could climb all the way to the top, and then Arya would only have to climb up 10 feet to get to the bottom of the rope.
Yeah, that's what we're going to do.
Yeah.
That's easier. Her falling 10 feet is not too bad, right? All right.
Yeah, she's scared, though, being alone at the bottom. Skeletons everywhere, okay?
Okay. Alrighty. So now I have a makeshift anchor, correct?
Right, so basically... So if Piper is kind of pushing the extra slack up to you, right?
Yes. Okay. She did that already.
Right. So if you tie the rope off at the top of that rope at 45 feet, you have 45 feet of slack to climb. As long as Piper...
Yes, math is hard, but yeah. Okay. And I still have 80 feet to climb still? Because we climbed 45 twice and it's 160?
You have 70 feet to climb still.
All right.
You got 160 feet to do, and you've done 90.
I'm gonna man up and do it, man.
Do it.
It's happening.
Just do it.
This is where I fail roll,
there
and it's
go,
all
yeah.
Go to hell. Yeah.
Climb up.
Just
do it. Okay.
Shh.
So yes, you're falling. The good news is you do have that extra tie off. How far up are you when you fall? You are 20 feet up when you slip and come swooshing down. We're going to go ahead and check the strength of the spear. Okay, remarkably enough, the spear holds your full body weight as you kind of just yank and dangle. 3 points of damage from the whiplash and smashing against the side of the rope.
Oof,
that's not bad.
Yeah, the staff probably got compromised, though.
Right. Cheerios! Thank you for the follow.
Woo!
Delicious.
The real root rot. Yeah, the real root rot. Thank you for that. The real root rot. Okay, Bess, you want to try that again?
Not really. Give Piper a, like, fuck me, look. Shit, man. See, no. It's not going in my favor.
Oh, God.
Okay,
no.
You fall at almost the exact same spot. This time, think of yourself, maybe I should avoid this little slick part right here.
This is so bad.
Again, it holds your weight, so Piper, you're okay. You're not having to deal with this right now. However, it hurt a little bit more this time, 4 points of damage. Yeah. Vestlar is going to graze himself to death.
What?
What are you doing?
This is not easy.
Shh. Fucking mad ops, go.
I am mad up. Jesus. Pelor, Christ.
Don't take Pelor's name in vain.
Arya, shut up. I go again.
Go on.
17.
Okay, this time you successfully make it. So you are now at 135 feet up.
Thank Cuthbert.
Fucking shit.
Arya, oh, sorry. So now Piper technically needs to come up with you, or at least as far up as the spear, and then retie off.
Oh, let's go to the spear.
But of course, you've got the spear supporting you as well, so go for it. Go for it.
All right, here we go. Spear rolling.
Here goes Piper climbing up.
This delay is...
Delay. I added the delay for extra expense. Expense, suspense. Okay, you fall after 30 feet.
Doesn't the spear stop her fall?
That's what I'm fixing.
No, I didn't make
out.
It to the spear.
Well, the spear might stop her falling to the bottom, yeah. But you're still going to be like, you know, that you've got 30 foot of slack to fall. Once again, the spear holds through, although you do kind of see it like bend, just a, not bend, but like move just a fraction this time.
Oh, no.
So it's a magical spear
Two
that's...
2 points of damage.
How much?
Two.
Two?
Yep.
Piper.
Try again.
Man up.
You guys.
Oh, stop a socket at Vest.
Fighters in armor climbing is always fun.
Sucks. Oh my god.
FML. Okay, fall 20. It's still holding on. 3 points of scuff damage.
This is terrifying.
It's just really funny that you guys are like just slowly but surely like getting butchered as you go.
Do it again, Piper. I believe in you.
Shh.
I'm whispering.
Sorry, how much damage for that second one?
Three.
And then roll again?
Yep.
Oh, man. I'm never gonna make it up. Oh my god.
Oh shit.
Yay!
A one.
Okay, so this time you're almost to Vestlar, like you're almost there, and then suddenly it's like, and you go zooming down. Alright.
I can't catch her.
You can't catch her. I mean, you're going to have to, you
yep.
can.
No.
She hadn't, well, she's not to you, sorry, not, she didn't make it to you, she almost made it to the spear, sorry.
Yeah.
Because she's like heading to get to the spear. Alrighty, you only take 2 points of damage.
What?
However, the spear almost dislodges. You're still there, but you're like looking at it as it's like barely, the tip of it is barely in there. You're like not convinced it will support your weight should you put all that heavy fighter armor and weapon and body weight on it once more. So you may not want to fall this time. If you fall this time, you may have to rely on Vestlar to keep you alive.
Yeah.
Or at least stop you from hurting yourself too bad.
Peppy can come back down if you want.
What do I do?
How we roll episode 32, how not to siege a castle. You guys. Alright.
Looking at Vest, like, am I doing this?
You're doing this.
Pep. Peer pressure.
Do it.
Oh god.
Oh my god.
Just do it. Okay.
Oh no.
Alrighty. You were 20 feet up, which means you are 65 feet from the ground. Okay, let's see.
Shit.
Alright, the spear does come loose, but it kind of, you know, it takes a little bit of the burden. Veslar, strength check, buddy.
Alright.
Save me!
Hey, it's if it... You're okay. If he gets pulled off the wall at 135 feet, it's gonna hurt some.
Yeah, it's gonna hurt some.
Shit.
It's gonna hurt some.
Oh my gosh.
Alrighty. Veslar,
you killed me, man.
Hey. The question is, are you... It's not whether or not... It's just that you're not gonna break Piper's fall. So, Piper.
Oh my god.
Okay. As you bounce and collapse down the side of the hill. 4, 5.
Stop it.
9.
Stop it.
11. Oh. Come back, D6.
Yes, that's what you get.
11, 12.
Stop it. 13, 14,
15, 16, 18, 19, 20, 21. 4. 27 points of impact damage as you smash at the bottom of the edge of the cliff face. You were the one that fell, right?
Okay, I wasn't sure if it was
Veslar. No, that was your that was your 80 foot fall.
I'm running towards you like Pip, are you okay? Pip.
Veslar.
Fuck, man.
How many hit points do you have?
52.
Alright.
So I have a question.
Uh-huh.
Can I pull the rope to me? With the spear, because it's still tied to the spear. So again, can I pull the spear up to me?
Well, you haven't fell yet.
No, I know, but right now, could I, if I wanted
to? No, you'd never have the time. You'd have to pull the spear up 45 feet, and Piper is
with
falling.
With the rope that is...
Right, but Piper's falling on that rope. She's tied to the rope.
Yeah.
So the spear is going down with Piper. As you start pulling up, you're going to be pulling... You're maybe going to have two handholds before she... is going to hit the bottom.
Well, she's off the mountain, right? She's off.
She is now, yes.
So if she just unties herself, then I'm attached to a rope, which is attached to
the
spear.
At that point, the question is the fact that you tried to hold her from falling and failed, so you're falling as well.
Oh, I'm falling as well. Oh, okay.
Right.
Got it. I didn't get that part. I'm sorry. So, yeah, give me my damage, man.
Okay.
49 points of damage.
So you're pretty much dead.
He's hits the ground, crunch. He's laying there on his back, barely moving. 49 points.
Are you gonna light? Are you gonna
damage.
Fucking light heal me now? Ari, if you light heal me, I swear to God, I'm going to kill you. If you light heal me now,
a little bit of blood comes out of his mouth. He's got blood trickling down the outside.
I am in tears.
No,
staring
Veslar
at my
is
two
down
friends.
To, how many hit points you on?
Dead.
3 hit points.
He's down to 3 hit points. That was all 3 more points, and that would have killed him outright. Because you were on 4 hit points, right?
Vess.
I was on 52.
Vess, what is happening?
I'm going to kind of look over and be like, shh.
Fuck my life.
Sorry. Here's for... Vess.
What's really sad is I'm not doing
heal
this,
Vess.
Guys. This is not me.
That's a terrible heal. Okay.
Okay, so Aria heals you for 18.
This one's for Piper. This is terrible.
Yeah, 20d6 is max velocity.
Moderate and heavy, yep.
Is that to me again, or is that to
Piper? No, that was to Piper.
Okay, so Piper's healed 18. You're healed 18.
Guys, we should probably go sleep this one off. Don't try to climb again, please.
So today's siege may not happen. We may have to temporarily put off the siege of the fort till another day.
I don't think the siege is happening.
That was for Vess. 10 minutes.
Extra 10 for Vess. There you go.
Yay,
so a total 21. Heal of 28.
Or you should know by now.
That
you
one's
throw
for Pip.
A little puzzle at us, how to get in a castle, and it's going
to
take 2 hours.
How to get in is easy. You're going about technically. I mean, this isn't a wrong way to do it. It's just you guys are just, You know, I mean, there are little... There are simple little things like, take the fucking armor off or shit. I don't know. Maybe buy some climbing gear.
That was the nine whisper you pit, by the way.
Okay. Even though Vesla is almost dead.
Hey,
but wait, I would have been, too. If I hit zero, I would not be dead. I'd be knocked unconscious, right?
Well.
Or is it different because I don't.
If you are on maximum hit points and you are reduced from maximum to zero in one hit, you die regardless.
Well, I wasn't at maximum. Right. I was like, I had taken damage prior to that.
Yeah.
So I was a little bit lesser. But, so it would have counted or no?
There.
No, I'm actually curious. Like.
Yeah, no. You're fine.
Yeah, but I was 10 less than maximum, but that was a big hit. Would that have killed me?
No.
It would have knocked me out. But if I was maximum and I got it all. Yeah,
correct.
Got it.
You go from full to zero in one hit. You don't get the luxury of the minus 10.
Got it.
But otherwise you do.
Okay.
Take 8 more, Bess.
There,
are those level. All Bess, the 10, the 9, and the 8?
You know, out of all nine, of those, out of those 13 dice, I only rolled one 1 and 3 of them were 6s.
If that one had been... Yeah, man. Shit, dude. All right, I say we go in the forest and we sleep and rest.
That's a great idea.
Now, fuck this place.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm gonna like limp.
I just saw my 2 friends almost die. Are you joking? We're not doing this tonight.
Yep, we're going back into the forest. We're gonna sleep, we're gonna rest.
Okay. All right. You guys make your way back into the edge of the forest, away from the edges of the fortress. Okay, here you are.
Are there any is that creature still there with poison?
No, you're not coming right back to that spot, I'm assuming.
We'll use the tentacles to climb.
Here, look, it's clearly not the same piece of forest, right?
There you go.
Look, it's obviously different.
Clearly
not the same.
By the way, I picked up the short spear, and I want to test its how hurt it is.
It's not.
How hurt are you, spear?
It's not. It's okay. Just with the constant eventually it just worked its way loose and it came out.
Makes sense. Okay.
I mean, it held probably better than any climbing spike would have done.
Because it's magical.
Well, the fact is that it was in the rock by about yay much.
And it's magical.
So, you know.
I'm just going with the magic. All right. Okay. I need to sleep. We need to sleep.
Good night.
Whiskey DK, you did not actually... You have not missed the interior of the keep because they failed to get in. They fell off the cliff and almost died. So you're good, dude.
Quality entertainment, guys.
Right.
We failed at climbing a cliff. Yeah. God damn it.
Hey, we rolled badly on purpose for your entertainment.
Yeah, we did this for you guys.
That's right.
I controlled those dice as well. 49 was, you know, deliberate. It was deliberate. Okay, so you want to rest up here?
Yes. Yeah.
Who's watching? And is anyone pulling a Veslar?
I'll watch first. No Veslars for me.
Okay. All right. So you're going to basically rest all the way through till morning because it's, you know, nighttime. So if you're going to have a full... To give Arya a full 8 hours, she's going to rest...
Good night, guys.
Yeah, don't you wish she was an elf right now?
She says creepily.
Don't die while I'm asleep. Okay. You're far enough in from the forest. First of all... Nothing natural would come anywhere close to this place, so the only thing you have to worry about is if there are any of those undead creeping around. You spend 3 or 4 hours on your watch. It's not a peaceful night by any means. You actually hear some strange screams from the distance coming from the actual keep itself. Like weird, like eerie. Painful screams, like somebody in the distance actually like yelling out in agony.
Oh, that's just Uncle Tommy.
What What's old Tom up to?
He ran out of his whiskey. The cable yeah. went out during
and
the
Kate just got a backhander.
Classic Tom.
Yeah, here's Aunt Kate. Shiggles,
she
man.
Finally saw herself in a mirror.
Ooh, but I'm bum.
Alrighty.
Wait, that sounded like Vesslar falling. Alright, so I'll take second watch, and I will not pull a Vesslar.
Okay. Alright, so, the moon has gone, the sun has come up, and you guys are still... I mean, it's still pretty dark here under the canopy of the forest, but, I mean, you can see a lot better than you could before. However, of course, that means that anybody inside the keep or looking out at the keep can probably see a lot better this time too. So it's up to you. What do you want to guy? You guys want to have a crack at this during daylight, or would you rather wait till nightfall?
I say we, you know, just heal up a little bit more.
Okay. So Arya, as it's morning, you do your say your prayers like a good little priestess.
Yes.
Do you want to do you want to like dole out any more healing?
Yeah, well, I was actually hoping to pick some different spells here, so just ignore me for a little while.
Alrighty. So, you guys ignore Arya.
Yes. I can't hear.
I'm going to be praying off in the
okay.
distance.
Well, we're actually going to take our second break because it is 9:30. So, Arya, you have time to peruse your spells. So I will be staying put. If you got any questions.